Good evening. It's time for the visit with the person of high strangeness. First things first, I want to show off my foot here. We did a show with a lady named Matisse. It was called Spiritual Vessel. And one of the things that we had discussed was how we sometimes are not in our body. And then as we closed the show, of course, I wasn't all in my body and I kind of fell. So the centerpiece today is my foot. And we are going to autograph it on the way out. So much for the chit-chat. I'd like to introduce you to my guest today. Her name is Gian. How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
I always always tell the friends how we met. Do you remember how we met?
Yes, I think what we met was we were neighbor, actually. And I think I came to your house or somewhere. I don't remember, but that's what we did.
You did, yeah. Mm-hmm. To refresh your memory, is the mobile home park where I live. One day they sold us, and so that kind of forced us to become neighborly. Remember?
Yeah, I think that was, and the landlord things with they have new laws and stuff.
Yeah, so we all had to see where we were and where we were going, and mm-hmm. so. Lucky for me and for the friends that I made your acquaintance. The name of the show today is called Between Two Worlds. And so what I want to do is I'd like for you to share first, what is the meaning of your name you told me, and that was so exciting.
My name, which original name or from where I'm from, village something, or what you mean?
Yeah, but what does it mean?
My name Gian. Mm-hmm. My name Gian is I'm from galaxy, between two destinations, mm-hmm. and Chinese and my hometown. Mm-hmm. That means is galaxy. Gian is from galaxy, between two destinations. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so, as we got to know each other, we shared stories about our homeland, and so I'm going to take my foot off this table because this is not so good. Here we go. And you're originally from?
Vietnam, mm-hmm. from jungle. Yeah, I was born in jungle. I came here when I was 13 years old. Mm-hmm.
Can we go back to your homeland for a little while, and maybe you could tell us what, like some of the customs and the food you ate, and we had a lengthy conversation, and I was just fascinated with that.
Yeah, as my homeland was, we just ate only vegetable and rice.
Vegetables and rice?
Yeah, mm-hmm. mostly. We don't eat any breads and all. We don't drink coffees and all, with no sugar. We naturally, we don't take medicine. Everybody live naturally.
It's all herbs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we don't take herb either. We just live natural, no medicine.
And you was telling me that it is a matriarchic society where the women do things?
Yeah. Women do things. Women, the boss, the family. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no men the boss family, but women. Women take care of men. Mm-hmm. So no family, stuff like that.
And the climate you said was pretty tropical.
Oh yeah, the climate, yeah, is. Sun all day, all night, beautiful sun. A rain come, but there's no cold like this.
Are they like monsoons?
Oh, probably, yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Did you have a large family? Did you come from a large family?
No, I have a very small family. Mm-hmm. Yeah, very small family, and I, the last one, the one-third of the Vietnamese own, mm-hmm. and we own my mom, and she married man knew that the United States call us stepdad. Mm-hmm. So, which mean we have messed up that. My mom's the head of the village.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the chief of the village. So, me the only one that liked to go United States when I was 12 years old.
Mm-hmm. When you were 12, yeah.
Yeah, and I wanted to go for so long, so I finally met my ex-husband.
So you have you have a lot of gardens and
garden.
Did the women work the gardens also?
Oh yeah,
I'm trying to sort of have you repeat the same story.
We had maybe one family, maybe like 1,000 acres.
Oh, that's a lot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We work hard. Yeah, 1,000 acres each family, a garden.
And then you also told me that you hunt.
Oh yeah, I have hunting, make traps, and mm-hmm. you know, for fish and stuff like that. My little fish, that's what we was eating. And my brother and I, we always go hunting. We had make some crossbows and mm-hmm. things, and you know, and we don't have anybody else that helps us to provide. We all provide ourselves between 6 years old and up. And I learned how to create clothing, and I plan cotton, spin the yarn, and make material for all my band when during the time that we had the party for Christmas, 7 days, 7 nights type.
Yeah, we was talking about that, and you kept calling it Christmas, and then we determined that it wasn't Christmas, it was the winter solstice. And mm-hmm. you just, what you related to was the dates that here that we celebrate Christmas.
Yeah, and times that we had, when we had sacrifice is different. Those mm-hmm. where we plan garden, before we start plan garden, we had sacrifice, yeah.
It was also a festival of the harvest, no?
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm. Yeah, but when Christmas is different. Christmas is Christmas like United States, but also we had big party for 7 days, 7 nights.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you said you buy a buffalo at that time?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we had mm-hmm. buy buffalo, and we put buffaloes on a Christmas tree, and also they kill buffalo as for sacrifice to the Lord, I guess. That's mm-hmm. what sacrifice we had, villages, mm-hmm. before we ask eat and party.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So.
And then you was telling me a story that because you were so in the mountains, when someone went to town, they came back with pans.
Mm-hmm. Yes. This is also different. My home, my village, we don't wear pants. Mm-hmm. So we all wear short skirt and split up.
Mm-hmm.
And little split up here. Like Tarzan, what was
it? Like Tarzan, yeah.
Girl, that kind of top we wear. Mm-hmm. That's how we wear in my home. And we came to town and we bought some pants.
Mm-hmm.
And my sister and I, we put them on and we kind of like, what happened?
Yeah.
Two close at both sides of the lake, and we just start kind of wondering why. So, and we have different, such different cultures.
Mm-hmm. So I see you in pants all the time now, so I guess you got used to having your legs covered.
Yeah, I wear a pant when I, right now I wear a pant when I was working, mm-hmm. but no working, I don't wear pants.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I still keep my own culture for many, many thousand years, I think.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So then eventually your life changed a little, and the war did reach your village?
Yes, I don't know. I have not came back, so I have come back mm-hmm. from my village, so I'm not sure what's happening. And I came here when I was a little girl. I don't know what my family saw.
So you still
my
don't
sister,
know?
Mm-hmm. My sister, my two brother and my one sister, and I don't know what happened to them. And I just don't want to come back.
You was telling me that you was doing a celebration when they raided your village.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how to say it, and just so much about this, I don't know what to be said, talking about communists and all, you know, it's so hard to explain it.
Mm-hmm.
It's so many don't understand it, how to explain it. There's so many things.
When I understand this is very difficult for you, and I remember at the end, you know, after we visited, we said that if we was to take one person a day and ask for their stories, we wouldn't have time to make war, right?
Yeah. And I don't have, we don't have, actually there are lots of Vietnamese, maybe some Vietnamese to understand the more English, and they can tell us about more what happened, why the things ended that way.
Yeah, well, politically, politically it doesn't really matter. What I was trying to share with the friends is more the your early life. See, I come from a country, I'm from Algeria, so in my country, they always had war too, you know, and that doesn't mean we understand it. And then, but sometimes it's really nice to go to your early memories and show the differences in people, you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I have not talked to my family, my kid, about I have been through when I was 12 years old.
Mm-hmm.
When my dad passed away, I was 2. And my mom, I don't know how you call it, just passed away or whatever.
Yeah, passed away is fine.
And I was 12 years old, and I started continue to find my own job, job to job, and try to survive.
That's something we found we had in common.
Yeah.
I was 12 years old when I had to make my own too. Oh yeah, and then you told me about your marriage customs. That was a good story.
Yeah. Yes. I have not married in my home, so as my sister is, you know, my brother is. We had married, when they married, my home was over here. They have to know each other so many years before they get married. And they, after marriage, they, what else, you know, there's nothing left. I mean, they divorced, whatever. But my home, when they appointed, who, if you know somebody, maybe a couple of days, and they know, and they appointed, and they have to marry for to those person.
So it's
and
an arranged marriage.
Yeah, and married forever. Mm-hmm. Yeah, everybody married forever.
And speaking forever, you was telling me that the people in your family got real old.
Yeah, like Mary told you, 115, 130.
So that's forever is a long time when you're married, when you live that long.
Yeah, I don't know what I think forever should be longer than that. I think, but that's as long as we can live overseas.
Do you think that has to do with your diet, or?
Probably, maybe some of it could have been like heart attack, maybe cancer, or get old. Some people are older than that, much, much older. They live, so I don't know. I can't tell because my mom told me when I was 12 years old before she died, she said, remember, you know, all these things that you have to remember that I told you.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody have to live longer or the thing that we have obey. You know, for 2,000 years ago, we have obeyed the rule that we cannot steal, we cannot lie, that lives longer.
Yeah, so it's practically a crime-free society that you came from.
Mm-hmm. something like that, yeah.
So there's a lot for us to learn from that, you know, mm-hmm. because now we will tell a person, you know, that's legend. If you do this, this is going to happen. In some of the Middle Eastern countries, that still works, you know, but mm-hmm. in this modern age, people don't believe you anymore, do they?
No. Yeah. As I came here, then I expect that mm-hmm. a lot of people respect you. Mm-hmm. You know, everywhere you work, and they don't respect what you're talking about. So you try to tell them, they don't understand or they don't listen because it doesn't agree what the rules are, maybe.
How old were you when the war finally reached you? Do you remember?
I was 11 years old.
11?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And 12 years old, I went to Nurse 8, Air Force Nurse 8 Marine. Mm-hmm. I've been there about a year between me to be Nurse 8. I take care of soldiers that wounds, everybody wounds. I take care all by myself, day and night. That time in the camp.
That's very hard to comprehend for us right now, because 11 years old into to join the military to be a nurse, that's a lot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, one person that's from Khartoum, I think she's a teacher's wife, she mm-hmm. invited me to say, you need to help me, but she never been there, and I only one that stays in the hospital day and night. Mm-hmm. Kid wound, everybody wound. People came from field wound and body back. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't handle, I just get sick because I'm so little in myself.
Yeah, that's very hard on a child, you know?
Yeah.
And then, I don't know if you're comfortable with this or not, but then the last few days before you left there, you and your family had to do a lot of fighting?
No.
No?
Nothing to do with my family and my home. Nobody can fight each other. Nobody.
I'm not talking about amongst each other.
Oh,
it's
here?
Just right before the you was able to leave your village. It was...
Oh yeah, that yeah.
Yeah, I'm going somewhere with that.
Mm-hmm. No, I just came here because I met somebody, mm-hmm. and I work with the army. With my ex-husband, mm-hmm. I met my ex-husband and play clean. That we work in laundry mat at an army base. Mm-hmm. So that I met him, and then he couldn't wait for me, and he had to go United States before me. So he contacted his father, was Lieutenant Colonel, mm-hmm. and his father's friend was CIA. Mm-hmm. So the CIA, he called CIA, his friend. He said, I had my daughter-in-law in Saigon, so I want you to go find her and bring United States for me. So that's what I came here.
Actually, I wanted to stay in your homeland just a little longer, and then, but it's just between two worlds, so I guess we can go back and forth if we want to. That'll be just fine, yeah.
Yeah.
Vietnam is sort of a real sore subject with people, and we don't, most of the time, we don't want to talk about it, but I'm just so honored that you've taken this time to share some of the things that you're willing to, because it's important that we understand that it upset your life as a whole also.
Yeah, sometimes it does, but you know, mm-hmm. at times like this, we just talk about okay. But a lot of people, when I met someplace in the bus and thing, you know, mm-hmm. they ask me all the questions, I just walk away.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because unless you really come from a place like that, and I can understand that, you cannot comprehend what that means. But each one of us, when we come, we bring something very valuable that is a lesson for another person, you know. And I shared some intimate stories about myself in my book, but not until then, because I just, sometimes we just forget, you know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I still remember, even if I, you know, be there only 12 years old, mm-hmm. I try to remember them all, but I couldn't sometimes. Mm-hmm. And that upsets me when I try to think about it, but mm-hmm. now, since I grew up a little bit, you yeah. know, I try to keep calm.
So did you raise your children bicultural, like in, did you raise your children solely as Americans?
Oh, yeah.
Or did you teach them both cultures?
No. They're just born American. Here, just American, because yeah. I have, my village is very little mm-hmm. language. And they ask me, how come you don't speak Vietnamese? Mm-hmm. Teach me Vietnamese. I don't speak Vietnamese. So when I was little, because my parents to meet each other, like, my dad is Chinese and my mom is French, so and then I supposed to be speak French, mm-hmm. and they teach me a little bit about it. I don't remember a thing anymore, mm-hmm. and I'm so glad that I came here just speaking English. Even I broke in all this English.
You speak really good. I mm-hmm. understand you well. But we've done shows in Korean. Well, we got an interpreter, but I felt comfortable enough not to, you know, have to call somebody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. When I was working with the Vietnamese people, they asked me where I'm from, and I'm from Vietnam, from mm-hmm. village. And then, how come you don't speak our language, Vietnamese language? I said, I haven't speak since I was born.
Yeah, now see here, that's the other thing, like sometimes, like myself, when we are between these two worlds and we make a decision, like myself, my skin is too light for who I am. Mm-hmm. And then when you speak to your people, they say, well, how come you look like that? And then mm-hmm. you go somewhere else and they say, well, how come you look like that? So it's really... Mm-hmm. Sometimes we don't know which way to go, do we?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They ask me all the time that how come your skin dark? Mm-hmm. I say I was light skinned when I was working Air Force Marine, mm-hmm. and I came to California as go to the beach all the time.
That's a good story. That's I should try that. That's a very good story.
Mm-hmm. Hoping my a little friend with a surfer, she's a professional surfer, and I dive underneath of a waiver. And she surfers, you know. And I hope her win the trophy.
Oh, surfing, a surfing trophy.
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful, yeah.
So that's why I get so dark.
Yeah, that's pretty good. If, supposing you could choose anything you want to, would you go back on a trip just to visit?
Everybody asked me about that, but mm-hmm. I say, well, I'm so scared. The time that I love, I'm glad that I love, mm-hmm. because it scares me when a little girl is scared. I don't want to turn my eyes back on, mm-hmm. but I miss my brother and sister, yeah. And the rest of it, I don't know. When you're a little girl, you don't know a thing about war, mm-hmm. and you start helping fight during the war, and that's hard for me.
Yeah, I understand that. You was in a location where a lot of Agent Orange hit you also.
Oh yeah, that was before when I went to Nurse 8 in the Air Force. Mm-hmm. When I was a little girl and it hit me. I don't know what's happened, maybe what happened right now and hit me and my face. It could have been from many years ago, mm-hmm. from Agent Orange that hit me. I have not eaten for probably 2 months, mm-hmm. and my stomach is pretty big, you know. Mm-hmm. It's on your body is on bone, That kind, you see that.
Malnutritious.
Yeah, yeah, you see that in South Africa, mm-hmm. that people live life in that.
Yeah.
That little boy, little girl, that's what I used to be look.
Yeah, it's really important that we explain to people that biological weapon, any kind of weapon, they mm-hmm. just not. Because we don't really know what kind of damage we'll do.
Yeah.
Even to future generations, that's a horrible thing to happen to people.
I know. It just, yeah. Things like that is really hard to comprehend in my life. But I'm so glad. I thank you. I thank somebody I am here.
Yeah.
And even work, minimum wage, I still survive.
Oh. Speaking of minimum wage, now we talked about that. That is sort of a little off the subject here, but we was talking about the fact that people get very upset when mm-hmm. When foreigners make Nike shoes and things like that.
Oh yeah,
you remember that?
What we talking about? That was Switzerland.
Mm-hmm. The sweatshop, exactly. Mm-hmm.
I think that would be nice that if we have somebody can respect us to do the same way, pay the same way, instead of someone that has better pay than we work so hard, we pay less.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
But unless I totally misunderstood you at that time, we arrived at the conclusion that even if the pay is lower for American money, I mean for our standards
yeah.
here, but when people work in the factories, did you not tell me that they get paid according to it's a good wage for that country?
I have no idea, because when my home, we haven't had any receipt. Wages, as you work, when I work as laundry in the army, I have not get paid. And that's about 5 months work, I have not get paid. I asked my ex-husband, I said, what happened to paycheck? Mm-hmm. I have not get paid. But when I work in the Air Force, they say, and I still get paid, but in 1 month.
Mm-hmm.
And $300 Vietnamese money, that's not gonna live. Everybody's starving in the village, and I had help. I buy rice for my money I make for the village.
For the whole village,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
I sell. Mm-hmm. I'm not working just for me, I work for the whole people.
Mm-hmm.
Medicine, anything that they give me, I give to my village who had been sick.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to offer.
But now keep in mind that was during wartime. But when we look at it now, is and we talk about commercial things here, you know, like some of the clothes makers and things like that. Because then, in my opinion, if we stop buying things, then people don't have a job at all. And are we talking about in the different countries?
Mm-hmm. Yes. I think so. If we don't buy from anybody, nobody has a job.
Nobody has a job. Okay.
Yeah. If we don't like each other, nobody has, you know, create a job
mm-hmm.
either. No humans on earth, everyone doesn't like each other.
Yeah.
So they have to have human, you know, everybody on earth in order for us to have, you know, creative thing and
yeah.
a job for everyone, I think, let's begin with.
So now we're going to flip it. So let's just, you left and the military got you out.
Yeah, mm-hmm. because no longer camp there, and it's called Plateau CE camp.
Mm-hmm.
That everybody's village was not village, it's called refugee.
Refugees.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They took off from village this time, 1969, 68, 69, we had a beautiful village. And the American soldiers take us to the camp. Mm-hmm. And after that, because they want to take us to the camp, close to the camp, because they're going to spray Agent Orange. Mm-hmm. So that's after that, everybody's stay. And those tents that they made, and we stayed at the tent, the little tent that they made. And now nobody has pans and pot to cook, that's laundry it, yeah. to wash, clothes to wear, because it's all destroyed. And everybody, that's what everybody die every day, every day.
Yeah.
Mm. So
it's
I
a,
had
it's a lot to deal with, and thank you for sharing that, because mm-hmm. I know sometimes when we go back in our life, it shakes us up a little bit.
Mm-hmm. All my girlfriends die, mm-hmm. except me, Leah. I only have two friends I think left from village. Mm-hmm. All my girlfriends die. I'm very strongly. I have very skinny that from Agent Orange, very, very skinny, couldn't have no food to eat. Mm-hmm. And I'm the one who survived nothing.
Well, okay, so we'll just get you out of that space now. And so you came to America, and where was the first place you lived in America?
California, Templeton, California. Mm-hmm. And the North Pass River. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then Morro Bay and San Luis Obispo.
Oh, I've been saying this, so this was a nice little place.
Yeah, and we came here and got divorced, and then I go to Detroit, find my own job, and left my kid with my husband. Mm-hmm. And then I came back here, and I wanted to go to school in Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. I have only $200 take with me. To go to Los Angeles, I wanted to go to school to be a designer. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't make it there either, because not enough money, not enough job.
Everything costs a lot of money here.
Yeah, so I went, stayed in a Catholic church with nun mm-hmm. for about 1 year. And Sister Mary told me that, why don't you go down to apply for actors? Mm-hmm. And they had actors downtown. And I went downtown, and I took the picture and I gave it to them. And we start standing in line. You accepted to be kind of like extra, but I mm-hmm. Second row. And they the first. Mm-hmm. And the first row and I the second row, and we act for a whole day.
Do you remember the name of the play?
The Doors.
Oh, The Doors.
The Doors is was the member Jim Wilson.
That's right. Yeah, mm-hmm. musical group.
Yeah.
Oh, how exciting. Yeah.
Yeah, I've been there. Mm-hmm. And I've been trying to do the commercial. Mm-hmm. Peanut butters and Toyotas and stuff, and I have not get through it because I don't have enough money to get my tape back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm good at that. But the time that I was doing the commercial, but I don't have the money, it will cost me about $500 for, to get the film done.
You like a demo, a portfolio?
Yeah, portfolio is like $500.
I've offered to be spokespersons for different places, and I for yeah. free, and I can't seem to be doing that either.
I have not gone through none of that. I said, well, I guess I don't get my job done, so I just continue to buy a job mm-hmm. as a symbol liner in Los Angeles.
And so your children are all grown now?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my baby is 23, she's on computer, and my boy is 24, he's in Tacoma College. And the other one is 27, he built the Olympia School over there. Mm-hmm. It takes 3 years for him to finish. that he trained people to build that school, finish, too.
Where do you see yourself 5 years from now?
Which means living or job?
Yeah, as a whole, what is it that you've accomplished a lot in your life, you know? So if everything was to stop today and you say, well, okay, now I want to do something.
Yeah, I know. I wanted to be able to find a better job. Mm-hmm. How I can live to what I want to live that age of my age, of the year age.
Yeah, now back to where we left off with payment in other countries. Mm-hmm. So now we're in the United States, and minimum wage is no better than not getting paid somewhere else.
Yeah, but I think, you know, as United States, much better than any other state, any country, don't you think?
Oh, I agree with you. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else either.
It was for service in the army or, you know, place that get help.
Oh, yeah.
You know, a lot of things like that. And people help other people from different countries that came here. Mm-hmm. And it helps with clothing, food. Mm-hmm. And I think that this country is so much better than any other country, and I know that for a fact.
I agree with you. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else either. I was just trying to compare that when we work for $5 an hour, because we do come from other places, mm-hmm. we're not so much better off because we still cannot feed the children and
I know.
Take care of everybody.
Mm-hmm. I've been working for so many years ago. It's still $5.
Still $5?
Yes, mm-hmm. And I don't know why. My experience everywhere works, every kind of work, mm-hmm. my experience, but it's still minimum wage. And I don't know why on that one. I like
yeah.
the answer why.
And then we are kind of, like you say, we are fortunate because we sort of help each other, you know, because we all have that background and that long story to tell. Mm-hmm. And so we're really lucky because now where I come from, we don't put a parent in a nursing home.
Yeah.
Do you?
I don't think so. I will not put myself to nursing home. I don't think so.
Yeah, because, you know, young people take care of the older people. And so if we can salvage, if we can keep some of these old ways and old beliefs that we brought here, I think we can make changes within ourselves.
They may, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think we'll change. It's not going to stay the same. Mm-hmm. But the pollution is maybe changing.
Yeah, that's true.
From the
true.
Air, people yeah. who build up to universe. Mm-hmm. And I think that will scare us a big one. People get pollution in the air.
There is a good possibility that you have health problems as a result of the Agent Orange, is that correct?
I need that, so, but I don't know how to get help on
yeah,
that one.
I don't either, and that's the reason I'm bringing this up. If anyone knows how to get her in touch with someone that that can help you with that, you know,
yeah.
Because I know the military takes care of, now that they finally agreed that that is a problem, the military hospitals take care of some of the people. But what about people like you that needs help and it just,
yeah,
you know?
I don't know how to contact or who to contact.
Yeah,
because
I live
mm-hmm. alone for many years. Mm-hmm. I don't have many friends and, mm-hmm. you know, people who I know, and I've been survival on my own along all these years since mm-hmm. I came here, United States. So
we were talking about verbal contracts too. It's like when in most places, like this honor system, the the way the law was set up in your village, for instance, like you said, you know, legend says you cannot steal and you cannot do this, and then, you know, people understood that. Yeah. And sometimes when we come from other places, we bring with us some of these old customs. Mm. And a lot of places, a lot of countries are set up on an honor system. Mm-hmm. So if you agree to do something for me or with me, for me that's a contract.
Yeah.
You see. So we have a lot to learn, because in America we got to get everything in writing.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Totally.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's true. So one of these days I will learn more about it, you know, what anybody can find me. Relation, mm-hmm. who that can be able to talk to me, and who heal in the first place, you know, who will heal Agent Orange. Mm-hmm. If nobody's healed, I don't know who else.
That's a long road. I have several friends that are afflicted with that.
Mm-hmm.
It'll just take a long while, but in the meantime, you know, we have to go to work, and we have to function. We just need a contract of some kind where we can look into that.
Yeah.
And then maybe at a later time, when things do change, double back and do another show on that subject.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so, because I have a lot of sometimes try to depend on my little child.
Mm-hmm.
My daughter, she had a lot of problem, can't find a job,
mm-hmm.
and that's hard for me to depend on her.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause, you know, I've been lived alone all this time, and I couldn't have anybody to depend on, but I would like to. If mm-hmm. I had find somebody, I would like to, you know, to contact people who will contact the people who can be able to have healing this Agent Orange.
Yeah, we need to speak up a little bit now. This summer, you worked in a tree nursery?
Yeah.
With plants that looked like hard work. I see you coming home from work.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's pretty hard work, but I don't mind. Mm-hmm. I don't mind hard work. If they pay me a little bit more,
mm-hmm.
I don't mind hard work. I always hard work. Women all this year.
Mm-hmm.
So I never complain about hard work. Construction is the only thing that I have learned from my ex-husband. It's only mixman, bricks and block, carrying, cut firewood. That's the only thing that I learned, all the hard work to survive. But after divorce, I have to learn on my own.
You're probably the only guest that has been littler than me. I couldn't work construction. It just, you have to be strong, you know.
Yeah, I was a weightlifter for 8 years. Mm-hmm. And I lose that, so that's what has provided me to be able to do things on my own. Lap finishes and all that on my own, move things on my own. But I need for change, know somebody else that would lead me the way where it, you know, a better job.
So yeah. If you needed to make changes, is that the only mm-hmm. changes you would
yeah.
make?
I need to change it.
Yeah.
If I get healed, I would go on, no matter what kind of work I work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's the only thing right now. Everybody keep telling me, why don't you work? Go find a job. I just laid off about a week ago.
Mm-hmm.
But who knows? I will work. I'll find a job just like that.
To be between those two worlds, is that a burden, or is it okay? We can adjust, huh?
Yeah, we can adjust that. I think I can adjust between two worlds, because the other world, you live a freedom before war.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody can tell you what to do. You're your own boss every day. You know. And when you come here and you need somebody to train you how to work,
mm-hmm.
I think, comes to work, somebody is still training you. You still need to find a job. Mm-hmm. What kind minimum wage or what kind of money they offer you, you have to go for it, I guess. But overseas, those times you don't need money. I never need any money. I live without money for since I was born to 12 years old.
So when the time comes and you have grandchildren, do you have grandchildren?
Maybe someday.
But not right now. Yeah.
Yeah.
When you do have grandchildren, would you like for your children to teach them about who you are and who your ancestors are?
If they want me to.
If you want to.
Mm-hmm. I don't let my kid to know about my privacy. All this, I was working nurse aid and be able to fight overseas, living when I was kind of a little princess in my village. I didn't tell my kids until they grow up, so they can understand me. I never told my kids since they were born until I came back from California about 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. That my daughter was 22 years old, 23 years old. Mm-hmm. So then I start telling them about what happened during those time. So I keep all my secret that time. Mm-hmm. So I won't let them to grow up first before I can tell them how I live. Mm-hmm. You know, how my mom died. You know, why is Vietnam War? And I still survive. All my girlfriends die, and I still live. All my village destroyed, I still live. I think I had a miracle
from somewhere. Yeah, I think you did. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we have done intercultural shows before, and one of the things we always point out to the friends, whether it's in Anchorage or Colorado Springs, well, wherever the show goes to, we're learning to be more tolerant and to listen to people from other places, and that's really helpful. Do you think?
I think so. Mm-hmm. Maybe, yeah.
So the grandchildren is, you see, when we come from other places, because when the men marry us, we did talk about that.
Yeah.
When the men marry us, they want us to stay the way we were when they met us.
Yeah.
But that's according to where we live. And then we come to America, and then we have to become Americanized. Mm-hmm. And then they don't know what to do with us.
No, they just, like, I had a hard time in the past.
Yeah.
Never been together.
Yeah, they want us to stay the way we were. Mm-hmm. And then when you ask questions, they say, well, you know, get a life, become an American. And then when we do, they get a divorce because they don't know what to do with us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I have no experience about American society at the time. Probably that's what they don't respect me for. Mm-hmm. But I'm very, very nice woman. Live on this earth, I think I never hurt anybody. I never fight with my ex-husband and all. My kid never did.
That sometimes is mistaken for us being dumb. And then when I became Americanized, I resented that because it was just the way we were brought up and what was expected.
I don't think
it's hard to be an American, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
You know, because everything is so different. And then between the two worlds, we let go of the old because our children are Americans. Mm-hmm. And then when the grandchildren come, that's why I ask you that.
Yeah.
Then it becomes important again to tell all the stories that we know. Mm-hmm. And then everybody is caught between two cultures.
Yeah, I had a little book to write on, to sew, and my grandma writing this book for me a long, long time ago. Mm-hmm. That would be so nice Mm-hmm. I think that would be nice if I know how to write it. That would be nice for my grandchild to look. And,
it is, yeah.
You know, she's a special grandma, and she mm-hmm. lived by herself for all these years.
Yeah. So it is important that we pass on what we know, whether it seems important at the time or not, but this is how whole cultures,
yeah,
you know, hang around for a while, if you will. Yeah.
That's, you know, but I think when my grandchild's totally look different, you know. Mm-hmm. And for me, I think my grandchild was, how come my grandma looks like Vietnamese and, mm-hmm. you know, kind of stranger to them looking, maybe, I don't know. But I don't look that bad, you know.
You're a very beautiful person.
I don't think I look that bad than some of Vietnamese people. If they had grandchilds, most of them, they don't look the same. My children look like Italian. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, then to go back to what we said earlier, the family that you come from, if you get to be 115, of course, you're going to look young forever.
Yeah, and that's what I imagine. My kid don't believe that. Mm-hmm. I say I'm going to live the 115 to 130, mm-hmm. that between those, what I, my grandma and grandpa, that's supposed to live on. So I hope that I'll live to there.
Mm-hmm. And when I first came, I had trouble finding spices that I wanted to cook with. Did you find that? Or?
No, I haven't got chance to. I haven't got chance to go look for it in mm-hmm. the store. So one of these days, when I got enough time, I'll probably go try to go look. What's the name of ginger? Powder ginger, something that you need to take with your body. You said then you need ginger powder.
Oh, ginger.
Is that what you need to look for it?
I have a total blank, but ginger is good for everything, mm-hmm. you know.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But I think you look good for your age.
Well, yeah, thank you. Yeah, that's the nicest thing anybody said for a while.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be running again in a few days.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then next year, we're going to try to do something about the apple tree in the middle where we live.
Mm-hmm.
Because this year, we wasn't allowed to pick the apples.
Yeah.
And instead, we have a great big bee's nest. Did you see that?
Yeah, mm-hmm.
It's just huge.
Yeah, I'm just curious, but I need to go back to this thing that we have to be done with. I need this better, if I can find mm-hmm. it. And I just curious about, I heard about on the radio, whatever, on the magazine. And for all eight, they can have the mall. I don't know where the location. I think I'm going to try to do that one day, mm-hmm. maybe next year.
Yes. So, in the meantime, we'll try to look into and see, you know, mm-hmm. what the problem is. Mm-hmm. But you're very pretty, and you're just a wonderful person.
Thank you.
And lots of stories. You're very wise.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I've been created on my own. That's why I wanted to be. Someday I might find somebody interested somewhere and let me know mm-hmm. for modeling. Because mm-hmm. I wanted to see what I can be able to bring on to that. Mm-hmm. If I can become all-age model.
You can be anything you set your mind to it. In America, everything's possible.
Yeah,
you know?
That's
yeah.
So I need my next step.
Your next
for step. Part-time, mm-hmm. something like that. I think I said, you know, that should be done if I get something better in the next 2-3 months or so. Mm-hmm. I think by 2-3 months, I think I get better by this.
Yeah, and then the other thing is when we come from a place that Then we come over here and we have learned how to drive and technology. Mm-hmm. And was that scary for you?
No. I'm not scared for anything. Mm-hmm. I am not scared for anything. And that's what everybody told me at my work. Vietnamese, I heard the Vietnamese speaking to say, how come she's not scared? Mm-hmm. I said, I don't scared for anything.
I was computer illiterate for a very long time.
Only computer, and I need to learn like you do.
That scared me, yeah. It did. I can deal with people, you know, and mm-hmm. and especially when you're from somewhere else and you don't speak the same language, we use our hands. And mm-hmm. I was talking to one of the camera people earlier today. You can put everything in numbers or music. Yeah. So some kind of way you can let a person know what it is you want. But when it comes to computers, that was really scary for me.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. One of these days, that will be scaring me on that mm-hmm. one. Because I learned on my own hand when I was working. I learned English. I didn't finish that. I never been in school in my life. But I jumped in Puget Sound College. Mm-hmm. And I didn't finish that. I went down south, take a class. I graduate electronic. All this board that I made, mm-hmm. I rewire and unfunction and non-function.
And it was so wonderful that you came to visit with us, and I thank you very much.
Thank
and
you.
We'll get together again and chat. Thank you for visiting with us. Okay. Until next week.
Okay, bye-bye. Thank you.